How do I remove a BIOS or UEFI password? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question that I've gotten periodically, honestly, for the last 20 years. How do I remove a BIOS password? I can't boot from CDs or USB. How can I fix this without knowing the BIOS password? I'll be blunt, you probably can't. BIOS and now UEFI passwords, which you enter before booting to allow the process to proceed, are really tough items to crack. That's mostly great news if you're trying to protect your computer. Unfortunately, it's really bad news if you don't know the password. So let's review a few of your options. The BIOS, Basic Input-Output System, or UEFI, Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, which replaces the BIOS essentially, is software stored in a memory chip on your computer's motherboard. It performs a bunch of different functions, but what we're most familiar with is it's the software that controls your machine from the moment you turn it on or reboot it. It's responsible for locating the boot device, loading the software that takes over then for the next steps of the boot process. I often refer to them as UEFI/BIOS to show that I'm talking about either or both, but throughout this video, I'm just going to call it BIOS. Many, if not most, BIOSes can be configured to require a password before you can boot your machine. It's a really strong security measure to prevent unauthorized access to that machine. If you don't know the BIOS password, you can't boot, you can't alter any BIOS settings, and of course, you can't reset the BIOS password. A BIOS password is strong security if that's what you're looking for. Given how often people forget passwords, it's almost too strong. Because if you forget it, you are likely to be SOL, severely out of luck. Now, there are a few things to try if you forget the BIOS password. Number one, hardware reset. A few computer manufacturers provide the ability to reset the BIOS password by setting a switch or connecting a jumper on the motherboard. The only way to know if this is going to work for you is to contact the manufacturer of that computer or its motherboard. The reason this is infrequent is that, honestly, it defeats the purpose of the BIOS password. A thief who has stolen your machine can just open the machine, flip the switch or connect the jumper, and get right in. Number two, a CMOS battery reset. The CMOS battery on the motherboard is typically used to provide just enough power to keep the clock running and to preserve your BIOS configuration when the machine is not running and probably not plugged in. Now, in some cases, you can reset your BIOS, including all of its settings and the password, by unplugging the machine, removing the CMOS battery, probably for a few minutes, and then plugging everything back in. Once again, this should be a rare case because, once again, it's horrible security. A thief could do exactly the same thing to gain access to your machine. All this does really is slow them down a little. Number three, a master or backdoor password. Now, I had actually not heard of this myself, but I'm told it's a possibility. Some BIOSes apparently have a master or backdoor password that the manufacturer can use to override the password you and I might set. Clearly then, step one is to contact the manufacturer of that motherboard. But how they proceed from there is unclear. If this is true, it seems like another security hole. Either they'd share the master password with you, or the thief, at which point you could share it with the public. Or they'd need some secure way to access your machine that honestly, I can't fathom. Number four, ship it back. I have heard scenarios where the computer manufacturer will reset the BIOS password for you, probably for a fee, but that means shipping your computer back to the manufacturer. They then perform whatever magic it is that unlocks it. Perhaps this is an instance where they can use a master password, if it exists, securely. This is a good theft deterrent because a thief isn't likely to bother sending the machine back to a manufacturer where it can then be traced to him. Nonetheless, I also believe this is a relatively uncommon practice. Number five, motherboard replacement. If there's no way to reset the password, there is no way to unlock the BIOS. One alternative then is to replace the motherboard, BIOS, and all. With a new motherboard and an unpasworded BIOS, you'll have access to everything once again. data on the hard drive is unaffected by switching the motherboard. Number six, replacing the entire machine. Sometimes a machine with an unknown BIOS password is unsalvageable. It's essentially been bricked. This might be the case with an older machine if the BIOS can't be reset and new motherboards are no longer available. It's a shame, but it's occasionally an unfortunate reality. If the hard drive is not password protected, getting a completely new computer and either installing the old hard drive or attaching it as an external drive is perhaps the most expeditious. Now, we do need to talk about locked or encrypted hard drives. Occasionally, it is not the BIOS that has a password, but the hard drive itself. For example, if you use whole disk encryption with a third-party tool like VeraCrypt, you'll need to provide a password or passphrase before the hard disk can even be read. That is completely unrelated to the BIOS. Now, it's easy to confuse this with a BIOS password because they both ask for passwords at roughly the same time before the system boots. It's difficult to know which one you're dealing with, so pay attention to the wording of the password prompt and any information that precedes it. The good news about a lost hard disk encryption key is that your computer is just fine. You may lose all the data on the hard drive and will perhaps need to reformat it, but the computer itself remains fully functional. Bottom line, yeah, remember your passwords. It should go without saying, but I'll say it anyway, remembering passwords is important, particularly those passwords for which there is no hope of recovery if lost. If you choose to enable a BIOS or whole disk encryption password, be sure to save that password in a safe, secure location, just in case you ever need to recover it. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4777. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.